Life Simmer, and welcome to Sims 3 Island Paradise Part 34. So there's this part and one more part, and I might just get them up pretty soon because we are going to try to end this LP. And yeah, so when we left off, Florida was pregnant and she was totally about to give birth, like she's about to pop. And why is this taking so long to load? Anyways, the big thing that I want to know is it going to be a girl or a boy? I really want it to be a girl, but we'll just have to wait and see. Caden kind of seems like he wants it to be a girl. With that smirk on his little face, you know? No, he looks like he wants a boy, but oh well. Anyways, so in this part, Florida's going to have thy baby. And yeah, there's only one more part of Island Paradise, so yeah. And Florida's going to age up once she, has the baby. No thanks. We don't want to talk to you. We don't like having friends, to be honest. Alright, so we're going to go shower. Caden's going to go perform some lifeguard work. And Kylie, why don't you go take care of Milo for a little bit? Look at Kylie in her onesie. She does not care about the world. Zoom into that booty. Alrighty, so she is going to go do that, and, well, she's gonna go pee, and then I'm gonna have her go give Milo some love and affection. And we're going to feed Milo a treat, talk to Milo, let Milo sniff our hand, and then we're going to brush Milo, and we're going to have some fun with Milo. Milo is Kylie's cat, for those who actually remember. I love you, but this is actually, like, Kylie's cat. Like, I got this cat for her, so, yeah, just thought I'd let you guys know. I got this cat for Kylie, so Florida's gonna go take a shower really fast, use the toilet, and hopefully she'll have the baby, like, super soon. She's definitely about to pop. Oh, we definitely need to, go visit Mr. Rubisol. We're gonna text him a little woohooty text and see if he's down to do a little woohoo with a very pregnant Sim. Sorry, I'm about to head out in a few minutes. Try calling back in 4 hours. I think he's going to work, so that kind of sucks, but whatever. Oh my gosh, a lot of people do not like Florida. Why? Like, okay, Carmen doesn't like her. Palmyra doesn't like her. Kylie apparently doesn't like her. Gus, her own son, doesn't like her. Shendel doesn't like her. Harley doesn't like her. And her, of course, her ex-husband, Theodore, is not going to like her. I never really got to talk to him, so let's, send him a friendly text and, see how that works. Maybe we'll have some more more affairs. I mean, I know a lot of you guys are like, oh my god, did Florida really just hook up with somebody? It makes things interesting. I can't wait for the baby. We're going to destroy Carmen's room and put the baby's bedroom in there. So let's actually do that really quick on camera. We'll go ahead and build the baby's nursery. This room, okay. In the series, I think out of all the rooms in the house, here's one. Kylie's is over here. I love Kylie's. I love the orange and blue theme. But out of all the rooms, I definitely like this one the most. I just love the way it looks. I mean, we could kind of just give that room right there to Eric. And we could take this one and convert it into like a nursery, because I feel like, you know, the set he has now, it could be used for teens, but I feel like it's more, I mean, look at the bed, guys, look at that bed. I feel like this room would totally be acceptable for him, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and give him the opportunity just to take that room, because I love it, I think it's so pretty, so I don't really want to get rid of it. But we're going to go ahead and paint the walls, and we're going to paint them. We don't know the genders, so we're going to be basic and create a yellow bedroom, and then we're going to go ahead and put in some, carpet. Yeah, I think carpet looked kind of nice. All right, and let's put in some nursery stuff. Yeah, I liked that. This is kind of islandy. So we're going to go ahead and plop that in there and just switch up the bed. The bedding. Why isn't it doing anything? There we go. So we're going to do that. And then let's go ahead and we're not going to do too much to it. I mean, we do have a bit of money, but I usually wait until the baby's born to even do this because I'm like really picky on like how I want to do it. But for now, we're just going to place a crib, and I think we're going to place a little picture on the wall for now. And when the baby's like actually born, I will totally go back in here and switch things up and make it a lot cuter and better and more them, I guess. But for now, we're just going to hang up some cat photos because we can. So yeah, we're just going to put some cat photos in there for now. Who knows? I have a feeling it's going to be a girl, but I'm probably wrong. When you want something, it's usually not going to happen. But never let your hopes go, you know, keep in mind that sometimes miracles and stuff really do happen, and, you know, things that you could only imagine actually do happen. Like, my channel, I used to, you know, say, oh, nobody will ever watch me, and I'm almost at 160,000 subscribers, and that's crazy, you know, just, you gotta keep chugging. Go to work at the Costa Verde Corporation and Alyssa's bookstore before time runs out. Okay, so Caden can actually go to work for a day. I think that's pretty awesome. I like that. Oh, he's saltwater deficiency, so when he gets out of school, he needs to, you know, take like a little dip in the water, and then he's gonna go to work. I think that's really cool. Alrighty, guys, I think I'm gonna go ahead and skip until Florida begins to pop out that child, and I will get back to you guys then. Alrighty, so the baby is coming. How exciting. Alrighty, I think we're going to have an at-home birth. I think that'd be kind of fun. So we're just going to sit here and watch Florida struggle pretty much. And people scream about it. I'm pretty excited for her to have this baby. Eric's like, Mom, what is taking over your body? He's so scared. Like, he's not even looking. He's so terrified. She's almost an elderly, and she's over here about to pop out a newborn baby. Kylie's like, shut the fuck up. Alright, so she's about to have this baby. I don't know why I'm so excited for this. Kylie just sits down and watches TV. Like, she does not care. Come on. Give birth. Caden's at work. You know what? Go to the hospital. Caden will be there. Caden will be able to get out of work and go to the hospital to go meet you. And I feel like Caden should be there when his kid's born. How beautiful he is. Okay, he is a beautiful Sim. Let me just show you guys. You know, he's really good looking for a Sim, if I do say so myself. Very nice, very nice. Alrighty, oh, look at this little bubbies. Look at the little puppies. He's on the beach just having a good time. How cute. Alright, so Florida's off to the hospital to have a little babies. Hurry up, Florida. I'm curious to know if it's a girl or a boy. Like, you are wasting time right now. Also, I think we're gonna hire a butler. I built a room in the basement. I'll show you guys that once we get home. I built a room in the basement for a butler, so we can actually hire a butler. Also, if I'm like lagging just a little bit. Sorry about that. I am currently rendering a video. So, let's go have this baby. This is where our little Eric was born. Oh, he's just going home. He's not even coming here to meet her. Oh, it was a boy. Oh, the disappointment. He was born with the athletic trait, and we get to choose his second trait. This is hard. Alrighty, so I picked the name Sebastian. We already have Eric, so I thought, you know, Sebastian would be kind of like a fun little... fun, and we're gonna call him Seb, or something for short. I mean, there's one part left. And we will give him the... He will love the heat. He does live in Isla Paradiso. He will be born and raised in Isla Paradiso. So I think, you know, loving the heat is probably something he should expect. So yeah, she just had her final baby, and how exciting is that? Let's get like a little glimpse at him. Even though they all look exactly the same, they're still so adorable. What I'm curious to know is what the babies are going to look like in The Sims 4. I really want to know because they're so diverse. Sims 1, you know, you had a little, like a little cradle. And you could only like feed them, play with them and stuff. And then Sims 2, you had, you know, a baby that would move its arms and legs. And like, if you downloaded custom content, you could actually put them in outfits. And then with The Sims 3, we got a baby that is wrapped in a blanket. So, I don't know. Look at the traffic. It's very versatile. It's really, really versatile. So now that we know it's a little boy, I mean, maybe the cat photos won't really, you know, suit him too well. But you know what? I like cats. So those are going to stay for now. And what else was I going to show you guys? Oh, the butler thing downstairs. Down here, I created a little butler room because I thought instead of having the maid come every day, this family owns a resort. Usually people who own a resort and like tons of boats and stuff, they usually have, you know, like a butler or something. So I am going to go ahead and hire a butler. It seems like the logic thing to do. Butler. Please make sure to have a bed arranged for me as I will be living at your place. Good day. Okay, I forget. In The Sims 2, I totally forget if the butlers lived with you. I don't think they did. Set as Butler Leo's bed. There we go. And I'm going to have, it's pretty early in the game, but a lot of the Sims are pretty tired, so I think I'm going to have Kylie actually go ahead and move the houseboat to somewhere kind of fun, maybe. I think we'll move it, let's go right here, I think that would be fun. Move houseboat here, and there was one other thing that I wanted to do. Oh, I wanted to read the resort's reviews real quick. So let's go ahead and, oops, resort management view. We are still not getting exactly 5 stars. There is plenty of food choices for my kids to pick from. Great job. The pool area offered something for everyone in my family. It was easy to find a place to relax and enjoy the warm sun. Great location. Quite a nice menu of enjoyable drinks. The hot tub was skin scorching good. In my opinion, the quality of food was average. The pool was way too filthy for me to want to swim in it. The buffet food was lukewarm and used very common ingredients. The landscaping made this resort feel very private. So, I think that's, I mean, it's not like we have a bad, a bad rated, resort. It just, we're not 5 stars, and it's kind of sad. But look at these werewolves. She's over here, like, destroying our furniture, and she could get it for that. And he's just watching her, like, can we go now? Do I need to wait? Can we leave? Can we go? If she ruins my furniture, I will ruin her life. In fact, let me get your name real quick. Shendel. Oh, I didn't know Shendel was. Oh, okay. She and that's terrifying. Shendel and Florida don't get along, and we just found out Shendel's a werewolf. She could totally eat Kylie. She totally will. Not Kylie, Florida. Gosh, leave poor Kylie out of this. Kylie did nothing. So I think the butler should be here by now. I don't know. Alrighty, like I was saying though, I'm gonna start putting a lot of the Sims to bed. Let me have Eric go to sleep in his new bed. And he actually needs to take a little swim, but I don't think we moved that much off the boat dock. Okay, here's the butler. Cool. But yeah, I'm just gonna have the Sims go to bed for now, and I'll get back to you guys in the morning. Alrighty, so it's morning time now. It's actually Florida's birthday, where she's going to become an elderly. So we're gonna go ahead and I think we're gonna throw her a little party, actually. I feel like that's kind of a big deal. You're turning into an old lady. So we're gonna go ahead and throw a party at our house and see who we can invite over. We are going to invite. Let's invite Carmen. Gus, even though he hates us, he is our son. Let's invite Rabuzio, and hopefully nothing too crazy goes down. Let's invite Theodore, her ex-lover, and some other people that actually like her, maybe. Oh, one person. Actually, wait, two. And yes, I think that's it. Birthday party starting at 11 a.m. and the dress code will be casual attire. Nobody needs to, get all dressed up and fancy for the birthday party. It's all good. You can come wearing nothing. We're completely okay with that. So I think I'm gonna have Eric skip school and. Oh, wait, no, he has a field trip today. Never mind. He's gonna go to school. And he actually needs to work for a day, so he's not gonna do it today. Tomorrow, he's gonna go to work because today he has a field trip, so that will be kind of fun for him. Are you ready to become an old hag? Are you ready? Are you ready? Alrighty, so I have a question for you guys. If you guys lived in the Bikini Bottom, would you guys go to the Salty Spittoon, or would you end up in Weenie Hut Jr.? Let me know. For those wondering what mine would be, I will meet you guys in Weenie Hut Jr. Congratulations from the second cousin, Eugenia. Don't care. I don't care about the imaginary friend. It's scary. All right. I'm really tired if you guys can't tell. After I film this, for those who are, looking out for Spam Saturday videos, just to inform you guys, I am going to take I can't talk. A little nap after this, and yeah. And then I'll come back. And, yes. So, Florida's party's beginning shortly. We're just gonna fast forward until it's time for her little B-day bash. Yeah, so I'm really tired on this part, and I'm sorry. So, I'm gonna take a nap. So, and whatever I upload next, I'll be more energetic and pumped and killing it. So. Yeah, but I think I'll also live stream later on as well. So that might be fun. But her party's. Sorry about that. I was getting a Skype call on my iPad, and that was kind of weird. Alrighty, so let's wait for her guest to arrive. Alright, here we go. Who arrived first? I'm curious to know. Terry Coffey, one of her friends that she met before we started playing her. And yeah, we're just gonna wait a little bit. Look at this. This hurts. That does. Look how much room she has. Like, you know, you could fit maybe four of her. Four little girls on this. A pedophile's dream. Crazy how she just drives off like that. I think this is her ex-lover. Who are you? Gregory, that's not him. Here's her son, Gus, the one I want to die. And here's her little ex-husband, who is actually really cute. He's a vampire. Which I'm pretty sure Rabuziel, the one she's having the affair with, is actually a vampire as well. I think she has something for vampires. Oh, okay. You guys remember, I keep bringing back, like, throwbacks. But in The Sims 1, when, like, people would come over, they would bring you, like, chocolates and flowers and stuff. When they bring food, that's what it reminds me of. I wish you could, like, just invite people over and they would bring you, like, a bunch of food. Okay, so Rabuziel, where are you? There he is. He's coming. He's like, give me a second. All right, cool. And he brought, what type of food did he bring? He probably brought something delicious. Ratatouille. I don't know what ratatouille is, but looking at that plate, it looks pretty good. I think ratatouille, I don't know what it is. But I know... For a fact, Ratatouille is an awesome movie, so that's all I gotta say. Alrighty, so we're gonna go over here and blow these candles out and become a little old woman. So many lovers here. Kylie's over here, like, fighting. Yeah, he's like, there's my ex-wife. Look at all the old people. Aww. Oh, look at all the little olds. Oh gosh, here's her three, like, lovers. And she looks so, oh, so ratchet. But there's Caden, here's Theodore, and here's Abuziel. So yeah, they're both vampires, these two right here, and Caden's a mermaid. And Gus is, like, not even cheering his mom on for her birthday. Whatever. Okay, Florida, show us what you're gonna look like. She's just gonna look nasty. Eric, only adults can use that. Don't know what they're talking about, nor do I want to know. All right, Florida has reached elder status. We have another elder in the house. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. You guys seeing her face move? That is scary. Kylie's, like, such a cute elder. Look at little Kylie over here. She's such a cute elder. Let me scroll over. Let me get that. Oh, gosh. Well, Caden still looks like he's interested. He has some wrinkles himself. How about these two? You have no wrinkles. How young are you? I mean, they are vampires, but still. Or Boozeal has a little bit of some wrinkles right there. Cool. Kylie's a little older now. Not Kylie. Gosh. Oh, I hate that I'm saying that. Because Kylie and Florida are, like, completely different. But we're going to come over here and change her appearance really fast. We're not going to eat cake. Sorry, Florida, but you can wait. Oh, Gus, now you're cheering. Your mom has already grown up. He's like, Mom, that's what you get for moving me out the second you moved in. Put the cake down. Florida looks so sad. She, like, looks so disappointed that she's old. Aw. Aw, she's, like, sticking her, like, little lip out. Look at him. He is sick. This little old man with his crazy tattoo. That's awesome. All right, let's go change her appearance and pretty excited. Actually, I'm going to leave that for the next part. And in the next part, that'll be our final part. And that's crazy to think. But yeah, sorry that I am so tired in this part. So I'm going to go take like a little nap and then continue hashtag spam Saturday. So I will see you guys then. And I'll just go ahead and tell you guys what videos are going to be going up today. Midnight Hollow, Generations, and hopefully The Walking Dead, and hopefully Friend Friday. That had to be delayed. But Friend Friday might kind of change a little bit, but I will tell you guys about that in another video. Friend Friday is like a series I have on my channel where every Friday I play a game with a friend, or friends, but I think I'm going to do something a little different for Halloween, and it might have a friend in it, and it might not. I'm not sure yet, but it will definitely be interesting, and most of you guys will like it. So I will see you guys in the next part, and I love you guys so much. Bye, guys.